At an election fraud hearing yesterday in Michigan, Rudy Giuliani, Donald Trump's lead attorney, brought forth their star witness, the woman who was going to blow the case wide open, because she allegedly, and according to her own testimony, has seen the fraud firsthand by looking in the Publix. Now, if you don't know what that is, that's a joke. She's trying to say poll books. And when I say trying to say, you'll understand what I mean after you watch this clip. Things went off the rails, to say the least. This woman that Rudy Giuliani brought in was absolutely off her rocker. And it was a beautiful sight to behold. Here it is in all of its glory. Rudy Giuliani's star witness.
The poll book is completely off. Completely off.
Off by 30,000?
I'd say that poll book is off by over 100,000. That poll book, why don't you look at the registered voters on there? How many registered voters are on there? Do you even know the answer to that?
No, I guess I'm trying to get to the bottom of this here.
Zero. There's zero.
So my question then is if the...
Guess how many... Wait. What about the turnout rate? 120%?
Let's let Representative Johnson ask his question.
So the poll book number, there's two things that could happen here. Either the poll book number, if ballots were counted multiple times, there's two options. Option number one is that the poll book numbers are not going to match.
They don't.
The actual. Not by thousands and thousands of votes. That's not what we see right now.
Take a look again.
Option number two is that they essentially were filling in names of people who didn't vote.
People too?
So is that,
Representative Johnson ask his question, and then when he's done.
I thought that was his answer. Okay.
Well, I guess my question here is why we're not seeing the poll book off by 30,000 votes. That's not the case.
What did you guys do? Take it and do something crazy to it?
I'm just saying the numbers are not off by 30,000 votes. So
I know what
I saw.
Are you saying
that they're filling in?
I know what I saw. And I signed something saying that if I'm wrong, I can go to prison. Okay. Did you?
Okay,
I'm just trying to ask you a legitimate question here.
Yeah, let's let Representative Johnson ask his question, and then don't interrupt him. And then if you want to respond to it, that's fine. And did you have more, Representative?
Yeah, I guess I just want to keep following back up with the poll book. So are we saying that the poll book is either wildly off or that they are filling in names?
It's wildly off, and dead people voted, and illegals voted.
Okay.
So that's my answer.
Now, I have watched this clip multiple times because this is the most fun thing that has happened from this entire election. I love this because it's kind of hard to tell. Like, one, everybody assumes she's intoxicated. She seems kind of intoxicated, right? I mean, she's sitting there like, I had to say I wouldn't lie or else I go to jail. Did you? I'll fight every one of you. No, she didn't really say that. But, you know, that's kind of how she was acting. We've all seen that person at the bar, right? Let's be honest. We've all seen that person. And if you haven't seen them, you might be that person. So option number two, she's not intoxicated, but maybe she has problems. In that case, she needs help. She doesn't need to be paraded out there by Rudy Giuliani and put on display for everyone to see. She needs help. And three, this is somehow, and this might even be the most likely scenario here, this is somehow an SNL sketch come to life. That's the only, I mean, the woman looks like she was, you know, put together that way for that appearance. You know, she kind of has a little bit of Selena Kyle from Batman Returns going on there. Pre-Catwoman, obviously. I'm dating myself with that reference. But she looks put together in a messy way. Like, you know what I mean? Like, she's messy looking, but it looks intentional. Like, it took a lot of work to look like that, as if somebody who's playing a part would look. The whole thing is nutso. I mean, I don't know of any other nicer way to say it. I know of a lot of more accurate but far meaner ways to say what's happening. But this is it. This is the best Rudy Giuliani can have. And you can see several times in the clip when he like reaches over like, could you please not? Can you stop whatever it is you're doing? But these are the people that Donald Trump has on his side. And these are the people that he firmly believes, or at least pretends to believe, are somehow going to win the election for him, even though enough states have certified that there's literally nothing that can be done to stop Biden from becoming the next president. No matter how many crazy people you trot out there to testify, none of it is going to make a difference. One of today's video sponsors is Surfshark VPN, and right now they have an exclusive offer for our Ring of Fire viewers. Go to surfshark.deals/ringoffire, and you can get 84% off a 2-year plan with 4 months for free. If you're not using a VPN to surf the web, then your data is at a greater risk than it should be. Using a VPN can help protect your data, it can help protect your privacy, and it can actually give you access to lots of features the internet has to offer that you may be missing out on using a regular web browser. For example, there's plenty of areas in the world where certain streaming services are not available. Using a VPN can allow you to get around that. There could be certain content restrictions on a college internet service. This can allow you to access more information. There's all kinds of things that VPNs can do, but the most important thing is that it helps protect your privacy, giving you a little bit more internet security. So again, go to surfshark.deals/ringoffire, use code ringoffire at checkout, or simply click on the link at the top of the video description below to get 84% off a 2-year plan with Surfshark, and you get 4 months for free.